What's up, guys? It's you, and welcome back to another Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire Replay OU battle that I had here against pkbreeder, and he's a pretty cool guy. I found him on Showdown, and we both wanted to battle ORAS OU, so we decided to do that. Looking at his team, he has a Mega Metagross, a Kyurem Black, which does a lot of different things. It's kind of scary, to be honest. He also has a Talonflame, which is either Life Orb, Choice Bandit, or Bulk Up. Then he has Double Genie, which is super scary, especially for my team, because that means Staraptor can't really put in a lot of work versus this guy's team, which is a little bit unfortunate, because both of those things are immune to T-Wave, so Thunderous his T-Wave support doesn't really help me out as much. And then we have Crawdaunt, which is pretty cool. And I brought my Bird Spam team, which is Scarf Excadrill, Banded Staraptor. I have my Mega Sceptile, which is Modest. I have Talonflame, Choice Band. I have Support Tyranitar, and Support Thunderous. So I'm just going to go ahead and jump straight into this battle. He leads Landorus as I go ahead and lead with my Thunderous. And at this point in the game, I'm just going to go ahead and go straight for the HP Ice, because I know I can knock him out. He makes a good switch into Kyurem Black. That does nothing. I'm just going to go ahead and T-Wave and get the full para turn one, which stinks, because that actually ends up mattering a lot in later in the battle. And it's one reason that this battle could have been a lot closer. But he's going to go for the Outrage here, and judging by that damage, I can tell he's banded, because that did so much damage. I'm going to go for the Iron Head, though, and he's going to hit me through Confusion, break through the Confusion, and flinch, which is good for him, and knocked me out with the Outrage. However, he's confused and on 11% paralyzed, so he's just going to go ahead and sack this thing as I get the free Mega off with my Sceptile, and I can knock him out with a Dragon Pulse. And now he's going to go ahead and go out into his Thunderous, which is fine by me. I know he probably has the HP Ice, so I'm going to go out into Tyranitar as he goes for the T-Wave, predicting that very, very nicely. And now I'm going to go ahead and get on my rocks as I live the Focus Blast, don't get parried, and get my rocks up, which is really nice. It's going to help me deal with Talonflame a lot easier. But now he's just going to go for the safe HP Ice to knock me out, because he doesn't want me doubling back into Sceptile. And at this point, I can just go straight back into my Mega Sceptile. And he was trying to predict my T-Wave there, or predict my switch there. He went for the T-Wave, ends up giving Mega Sceptile plus one, which isn't too big of a deal, because he does have Talonflame, which can just come in and revenge it. So he goes into Talonflame right now. I'm going to make the switch out into Thunderous, and I'm going to take this surprisingly well. Like, I have no HP investment, and I only took 36%. I find out it's because he's Life Orb, which is pretty crucial, and is going to allow me to take him out with the T-Bolt right here, because he was going to go for Flare Blitz, and he's a bulkier spread, which is pretty cool. So now he's going to go ahead and go out into his Crawdaunt, thinking that an Aqua Jet would kill me, but alas, it does not. I'm able to tank that out relatively easily and hit him with the T-Bolt. And at this point, I am in a position to where I think I can win. Right here was a little bit of an unfortunate scenario for him, because I'm going to go for the T-Wave, and I'm going to get, I'm not going to get the para this turn. If he would have broken through this next turn, it would have been really helpful for him, and this would have actually been a really close match, but unfortunately, he cannot break through, meaning he can't knock me out with the next Bullet Punch, and I will knock him out with the next Thunderbolt, which really sucks for him, but, like, he may have actually won that battle if he had not been paralyzed, but he's just going to go out into his Landorus, and I'm just going to go ahead and click HP Ice, which, you know, it's a little unfortunate that he had to get haxed a little bit, but I thought that was a pretty good game. It shows off one of my new Bird Spam teams, which I really like. I wanted to bring you guys a battle with a different team, because I have been using a lot of Mega Metagross lately, and the reason I've been using a lot of Mega Metagross lately is because I've been talking to a lot of people in the OU chat, specifically a lot of the moderators, and they've been saying that Mega Metagross will not be quick banned. It's going to stay around in OU for a while. It'll probably be A plus rank or S, but it's not going to get banned, at least for the short term. So I've been building a lot of Mega Metagross, and that's why you guys have been seeing a lot of it. And you know, I'm making some fun laddering teams. I can't wait for ORAS to come out. It's gonna be a great time. So if you guys did enjoy this video, please make sure to leave likes. It really just helps show support for the stuff that I'm doing here on the channel. Also, make sure to answer today's comment question of the video, which is which mega are you guys looking forward to using the most that won't be immediately quick banned? Because like Salamence is probably gonna get the ban hammer right out the gate, because that thing is so good. Like I think a battle I had like 2 or 3 days ago, I've narrated like 4 of them today, because they're a lot of fun to narrate. but you guys saw that, like, you force a switch, you get a dragon dance, and it's pretty much over. But yeah, just tell me which mega you guys are looking forward to using the most when the meta kind of settles down a little bit. I'm really looking forward to Mega Metagross. But with that, I urge you guys to subscribe if you guys are enjoying the constant content. And with that, I'll catch you on the flip-flop.